Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, wherever you're watching this from, whatever time it is, I hope you're well. We're going to be doing something a little bit different today. We're playing on the MFME emulator by the late, great Chris Wren, who unfortunately left us a few years ago, way, way too early in life. But he spent his life, literally his life, dedicated to creating this emulator. And this plays fruit machines, old-fashioned fruit machines, where the reels actually physically span. There was a mechanics inside, electronics inside, and a few other bits and pieces. We're going to play this a little bit different to how we normally do our videos. I'll explain on the first video, but first we are the Gentleman's Picks Club. You know this because you're here, and we are going to be live on Thursday the 22nd of February at 2100. If you've got some time to spare, to lend us your eyes, lend us your ears, and you know what, turn off your brain for a couple of hours, we would love to see you here on one of our live streams. This will be the fourth live stream we've done. I've loved doing the live streams, and you know what, enough of that, let's get on with the main game. So this is a fruit machine loaded in. As I say, these are machines of old, and the fantasy we're playing is these would be everywhere. You'd find them in strip clubs, you'd find them in pubs, you'd find them in Chinese restaurants, you'd find them in nightclubs, you'd find them in brothels, you would find them all over the place. And these particular machines, you just put coins in and you won money out. The way we're going to do this is we're going to have a little fantasy in our minds. You know, we have 10 of your British pounds left, and I'm wearing a British hat here, and we're going to put all 10 pounds in this machine. So let's do that right now. Here we go. And it errored because I put a coin in too first. Trust me, this machine is very accurate. So we should get 50 credits. Here we go. And one more. And all these machines and everything can be downloaded from a site that I used to actually own called Desert Island Fruits. And I gave it all away. But no, that aside, we're putting £10 in here. So whatever money we win out, we will take to another machine and try and increase our profits. Because the longer you play on these, ultimately you will lose. As time goes on, you will eventually absolutely lose. But no, we've got 50 plays in here at the moment. And if we win £8.60, for sake of argument out here, we can only put £8 into the next machine. But we're going to keep playing machines until we either go bust or we get the £100 to buy, in our minds, the missus a present. So let's start. This is Monopoly. This was a great machine. This was the 60th anniversary. And thank you to everybody that has created these machines that I'm actually... I used to create some of these myself, actually. That's actually created these machines that we're using in here. I can't list the names because of the way they're actually showing them, because I can't see the names. But no, thank you to everybody. If you create these machines, you know, you may see one of yours. And these machines are run off the real firmware, the real ROM. So this is no... simulation. This is pure emulation. They play exactly as they would based on the code that's running on them. So anyway, Monopoly was a great old machine that you had here. You know, basically you got to work your way around the board. And Win Series would be the top one when you get the two Mayfair and Park Lane, I think it was. And we're going to start. So, you know, basically we spin these wheels. We spin these wheels and they go around. And when we light the Monopoly up, we basically can then get onto the center board. So we've got nudges here. So we can nudge down and nudge here, and nothing happened there. Sometimes you get a hold flash on nudges, and then you can press start. And on some machines, it will spin in the win. So we're going to see how much we can get with our £10 that's in this machine. Hopefully, you know, we'll get a decent amount of money out. We can choose to put it back in, or we can go and take it away and play another machine as well. So, you know, we're nearly out of £2, you know. There you go, this is our £2 there, and no wins so far. So not going particularly good. And this is where we can gamble nudges. So I could hit space for the start to gamble them. So we've got two nudges, and it's flashing Monopoly. So we're going to hit E for exchange. That's going to take us into the feature, and boom, here we go. So this is where we go around the board on the main feature game. And what we're looking to do, we're looking to basically get some of these win series wins on the right hand side and be good with profit, good profit. So we've got this property here. We're going to go around again, and if we light all these properties, we then effectively light up the prizes on the right hand side. If we could get the £10 out of here, that will be great as well, and we will absolutely take that. But we could collect £1.40 so far. Well, we don't want to do that. We want a lot more money than that. Take a chance, we spin a card. And we got extra nudges. So what's this going to give us? It's not going to show us the nudges yet. Okay. All right. So all those nudges for £2 only. That's not very good. Okay, community chest, community chest. Go to jail, no! Okay, we're in jail. So we've got to land a double, and we got a double. Oh, we didn't get a double. No! Good lord, my glasses, I'm blind. Right, okay. So we are not doing so well here. We are not doing so well at all. We are going to be going home in shame. Sometimes on features like this, you can hold the cancel button down to actually slow it down, but it's not allowing us to do this. But we can hold the cancel button down, which slows down the skill stop. Oh, I missed. Oh, how could I miss? Of the years I've played Fruit Machines, and I miss. Okay, four nudges. Okay, we can exchange into Monopoly. I did have a win there, but I gambled it away. I gambled it away because things are looking quite dire. We have nearly turned our £10 into not very much money. So, we can collect a pound. That isn't going to help us on our mission. We can collect £1.60. No, we've got to keep going. £1.80. Oh, what's this going to be? Take a trip. Okay, randomly flashes everywhere. So we are £3. Oh, okay, we've collected £3. So that's at least £3 for the next game that we choose to play. And here we are, trial held on the Monopoly. So if I hold reel 1, 2, and 3, that will take us into the feature as well. So currently we've got £3 for another machine. Okay, we can put that £3 back in this machine, but that's not the gameplay. That's not the gameplay to do that in our little twisted game where we've got to get 100 quid. Go to jail, no. That's all we needed. Alright. And we didn't make it. Alright, so we've now gambled and we can take that £3 down. In fact, that we collect. And we can take that down. And that down, and we've got a pound, and then we got the high low build. So here we are, we go higher, it's 1 to 12 here. So if we go higher, we might get an exchange if we basically do okay. And yeah, that's fine, I'll take that. So let's do E for exchange, and we're back in the feature board. I'm gambling, obviously, no pun intended, on being able to do okay here. To do okay, so £2. We can win £1.60 there. Oh, what's this going to be? What's it going to be? Double or chance? Oh, let's take the chance. Take a trip. Okay, what's it going to do? And we won a pound. Okay, so we've currently got £4 to take onto the next machine. So we're going to hold that 2. Because we were trying to build the Monopoly. Every number lights up, so this will take us into the feature. And you know what? We're going to hold the middle one just to stop another cherry arriving there. So there we are in the feature. So quite a bit of feature gameplay here. I'm hopeful we might break even. I don't think we're going to do any much more than that. Because you know what? This isn't being very good to us. Throw a double or take a chance. Yeah, we'll take a chance again. What's it going to do? Take a trip, okay. So, oh, that's all right. So here we are. Although this machine has gone pretty badly, we're halfway through our money and we've got £8 so far. So we're slowly crawling up in our fantasy world to be able to buy the missus the most expensive bunch of flowers for 100 real British pounds. Oh, come on. I would love to be able to get effectively more than my £10 here. I really, really would. Okay, so we've got a bonus here. We got this bonus because of the diamond one in the middle. And the plus numbers, it didn't do very much for us. Let's hold those two, you never know. And nothing happened there. All right. So these machines, they had like little jackpots like here. These were known as AWPs. You know, these were awards with prizes. And one nudge, right, we need more than one nudge, so we can't gamble. All we can do is nudge something down, so let's bring that down, and nothing happened. But yeah, you've got club machines that have the big jackpots, And you know what? If we get a decent pot of money, we might go to the jackpot machine to try and get a good prize out. But you know, you don't know. You don't know whether you're going to be successful. It is all, you know, not luck, because some of these. Oh, I can hold cancel to slow this down, I think. And focus. Ah, oh, it didn't light all the way up. Never mind. Yeah, so you can have some skill in these games if you know the tricks and things like that. But you know, we don't really know those, so we're just playing like your average drunken punter. Right, choose a trial. Oh, yes, yes. All right, we're back in the feature. All right, so best win £3. 10. Right, give us a 2. No, aye. £1.80. £3. Best win £3. All right, let's go, let's go, let's go. Take a trip. Where's it gonna go? Ah, bugger. So £2.40. Right, so we have broken even. We have broken even. We have got our £10 back now. So we can get back into the feature board. There we go, because we lit up all the numbers there. And we're going to go on again. You know, this generally was like real life as well. You know, I've been playing machines when I was a very young nipper. Because I used to have them in Tap Town centres as well. You know, obviously I was too young to be going into brothels and strip clubs then at that particular point to play these. But no, you had them in town centres in these little arcades with all these machines. And, you know, I was been in there having spent money on the wrong things when I was sent out to buy stuff and tried to gamble money legitimately to get enough money to get a bus back where I was meant to be going. Hounslow in the United Kingdom, not too far away from Barnsley, was one place that I did this. Right, how are we doing? £2.60. Right, let's keep going, let's keep going. Oh no. Declared bankrupt. Oh, curses. So bang, that's dead. No matter how well you think you're doing, that is dead. So probably one last chance to get into the feature board, because we've got 5 goes left. Okay, what's this gonna do? Numbers in view. Yes, we're in. We're in. Alright, we've got to make this one count. We've got to make this one count. So keep going, keep going. We want £100. Not that we're going to get it on here. Not that we're going to get it on here. Throw a double or take a chance. We'll take the chance. We will take the chance. Take a trip. £1.40. Oh, we're 20p off £2 profit. Alright, so by the logic I have here, we have £11 to put into the next machine for the next challenge. So let's collect that money. So that money is collected now. Imagine this, we're going to take a little wander around the arcade. We'll take a little wander around the arcade to find the next machine to play. So here we go. Please wait as I walk around. I'm walking around having a look, thinking, yep, what are we going to play next? What are we going to play next? You know, there is going to be so many choices. There's going to be so many choices to do. And I've literally got to find one that's going to be fun. So here we are. We've walked up to a machine. You know, the machine is powering on, even though the machine would have actually been powered on already. For this scenario, the machine is powering on, and we are going to be playing the most wonderful, wonderful, wonderful Rocky Horror. Okay, this was a great machine. This was a brilliant machine here. So we're going to put our £11 in, and we notice that it's only a £10 jackpot as well. But, you know, hopefully people haven't played this for a while. And the way the emulator works as well is it remembers the last play and how it was. So the RAM of the machine, you know, you go back to it and it loads it in and it plays literally as it was last left. So let's put our £11 in here. Where is zero key? There's 0, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11. Now you will notice But there's actually less goes on here for £11 because the last one was 20p a go. This is 25p a go. But yeah, no, we've got our £11 in there. Off we go. 44 plays to make £100. Right, okay, so we're going to go for the sevens. There we go. And they flashed. It said let them spin, so we're going to do that. And we've got a pound. So we could do high-low on the five reel here, which you see on the top middle. So we're going to go higher. And obviously we can only go lower when you get a 12. I'm going to go higher again on the three. And you know what? I'm going to collect that. I'm going to collect that, I think. So we've got £2. You know, we've made some money back already, and we can hold again. So after a win, sometimes you get a repeat. All right, so now we're going to go higher again on the five. How pathetic. And yes, how pathetic. We lost. But if I could have got back in there, that would have been nice. So you can get into the main feature by lighting all the time warps on the right hand side. But no, we've got the three sevens again, so we're now effectively back on the high-low reel. And we basically don't want a 12. Okay, and we want something higher than a 5. And we didn't get it. So this could be the machine that causes us some trouble. So the time warp is going to be a feature. Can we slow that down? No, we can't slow it down. So this is shots. Shots, basically, if you get them, if you hit it when it's lit, you keep your shots and you move up to the prize trail. How pathetic. Yes. But it held. So all you need is numbers. When it flashes like that, all you need is numbers. And though, there you go. We don't get numbers. All right. So not very good. You know, at the moment, we have converted our £10 into £2, which is quite tragic. All right, let's bring down that and that. And it did nothing. All right, hold that reel. The pelvic thrusts. Yes. Step to the right. All right, so we get another bonus feature. This is very much like the diamond one on the Monopoly game. Okay, nudges. We're going to bring down the Rocky Horror Show. I was hoping it was all going to flash, so it would then spin, and we would get £10. Oh, so it's holding. Come on, give us some numbers. Oh, you bugger. Step to the right. This perhaps wasn't the best machine to choose. Because we have damaged our bank, we have damaged ourselves here. Alright. So let's keep going. He's in tight. You know, by doing a silly bit of mental simulation like this, you know, you're actually recreating the stress of when you legitimately were trying to win money to deal with a problem you had created yourself. It's quite uncanny, actually. Come on. Hands on your hips. Alright, so that one there. Starts to drive you insane. Look at this. Our money is almost gone. 14 more spins. Jump to the left. Then we've only got £2 to take onto another machine. Okay. Okay, it's held. Please, just one number. There we go. Alright, so exchange at 160. It's on number one. So we're going to go higher. And we're going to exchange to get into the feature. Alright, so we are the flashing green guy at the bottom. Let's press space to move it. And we've got £1.60, but the only tube we've got lit up is basically the Grab It Janet tube, The other ones are not lit up yet, so anything we get in those tubes doesn't matter. Come on, come on, come on. Four nudges. What would four nudges be? I don't know. Nothing's lit up. So the Grabbit Janets might be the ones we've got to take. If Nudges lights up, that would be good. At five nudges, we can hope for something. Seven nudges. Come on. Alright, okay, maybe we can get land on the green guy. Oh, this could kill us. This could absolutely kill us. But this song that you've got here, there was a brilliant video on the remake of the Rocky Horror where she was singing this at the beginning. I can't remember the singer, but what a great opening for a not so good sequel they did. But the beginning looked fantastic. If you know what I'm talking about, great. If you don't, do a search on YouTube for this song, Science Fiction Double Feature on the Rocky Horror remake. And we got Tubetastic. Oh, good lord, we're going to probably be dead. Oh. You know what? We're going to take Franken Feature. We're going to take Franken Feature here. How'd you do? Okay, let's just gamble. Let's do a gamble. Oh, no, we lost. All right, real war. What is it? What is it? What is it? Oh, we get the best win we can with what we've got here. Cancel. Right, it's going to be the yellow bars. That's it. Damn it. Damn it, Janet. So we've won. £5. Jump to the left. All right. The pelvic thrust. On some machines, when you get three numbers in a row, it will take you into the feature. Not this one. Not this one. Okay, nudges, nudges. What's it going to give us? Nothing. Let's bring that down and that down. I was hoping for a quick flash to give us a respin. Alright, into the time warp. So stop the reels. Have we got something with a prize of five? Yeah, we have. We got one here. We can get five. There we go. We're in. Exchange at £1.60. Damn it. Alright, let's gamble it and hope. Come on, please. Yes! You know what, let's go risky one more. Now we're going to do exchange. We might get our money back. Okay. £3 there. So we've only got Franken Feature, the right-hand tube at the moment, because the top buttons are not lit up yet on anything else. You tricked me. Oh, gamble contents. You know what, we'll take that. Four Grabbits. No. No. Anything above £2 we will take. We will take that. Oh, we're only £1 down. I thought this machine was going to absolutely stuff us the way it was going in the beginning. He's in tight. Start to drive you insane. Oh. What's nudgeable? But let's try that. Oh. Two nudges. Alright, let's try a nudge warp. Ah, bugger. Oh, the final win. And we got nothing. So we got £9. Collect that. And we have £9. So we've taken 10 to 11, back to 9. And we are going to bring up the display again as we move to pick another machine. So, you know, we've now got to make a lot more money than what we had there. So, you know, everybody remembers Noel Edmonds. Yes, we all remember Noel Edmonds. Is there a deal or no deal that we can play? Is there something to do with Noel Edmonds that we can do to find a deal or no deal game? And yes, there is. There is my favorite deal or no deal game that we can play. And this game is called The Crazy Chair. So when you fire up the emulator, it basically fires up the machines, loads up the machine. So this is the machine initializing. You know, it's like you've turned it on for the plug. So you turned it on at the plug for the first time, and bang, it's booting up. Or you've turned it off and you've turned it back on here. But we have basically got £9 when this machine boots up to get as far as we can. And this is a £70 jackpot machine. Now we could change the stake from 25p to 50p to a pound. This one is multiple stake and prize. I'm really not sure what we should be doing. I think for the sake of this video, we're actually going to be changing it to probably the 50p stake to give us 18 goes, 18 shots here. But let's put the money in anyway. So we are going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and we're going to change our stake to 50p. All right, so if you don't know the deal or no deal game, hopefully we'll get in the feature board so we can see it. But yeah, this is our shot. We need to buy something for the missus now. This £9 has to be in £100, otherwise she isn't going to get flowers. She's going to get weeds that we pick off by the side of the bus stop as we try and get on the bus without paying, with a cluster of stinging nettles that we've picked up from the brick wall that was growing out by the bus station. Anyway, off we go. So, okay, if we can light these boxes, this could be good for us as well. The deal or no deal boxes help us get into the feature. But look at this. Oh, 50p.
Good one.
Oh, we're in. All right, so we're in the middle box now. So we're going to basically press space to spin. Oh, and we're on £4 as well. And you know what? If we go lower here, that will give us more cash. Okay, we're on £8. You know what? We need to collect that. So glorious, glorious. Just when you thought it was over, it's not quite over, because we've got £8 back. We're nearly back to our starting stake, which is glorious for her. And, you know, I'm trying my best to keep this going along. You know, this is the stress you would get in the real arcades as you're trying to increase your money here. This was quite a prude move to be doing, actually. Oh, £10.
Good one.
Oh. You know what? We're going to collect. We're going to take that £10. We have suddenly made an unexpected profit. So let's collect all that. Come on. Hear the money falling out. Right, so we have now got £18. And we need to bring up this again. Because you know what? We are going to change machines one more time. We have to change machines, because you know we've got to change this into the glorious profit for the flowers. Of course, it does beg the question as to what are we going to be playing next. Everybody likes The Simpsons. Most people like The Simpsons, actually not everybody, but most people like The Simpsons. So let's go for a Simpsons inspired machine. And this is the Duff Beer Guide. Okay, so it already had 5 credits in there for some reason. So whoever played this last walked away and they left this machine with 5 credits in. But you know what, we've got a little bit of money to put in as well. So let's put in the first coin. No, come on, where is it? There it is. The first coin. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh. So, it had a problem there. It had a problem there. So we're effectively calling the manager up. I obviously overstacked the coins here. So we know we've got 9 coins in there. There we go. So 9. We're not going to put any more in. So we're down to basically £9 here. And we had the bonus credits. So we're already in there as well. So that's fine. But we're going to play these to see what we got. So we've got £9 already. Floats. We're not putting any more in this machine. And we're going to play these credits here to see what we can win. To see whether we can actually get some more money. I used to own this machine, actually. I used to own the physical one of these machines. Okay, let's nudge you down. Well, probably not going to do very much, but it had its error as well. This is what happens. We wake the money on Deal or No Deal, and then we wreck it on here. We wreck it on here. Oh, I was hoping for the spin. Not going too well. It's not going too well. And it plays so fast. Look how fast these reels spin compared to some of the others we've played. It is a super, super fast machine at eating your money. Actually, let's try and hold that to see whether we can get into the main feature. Yes, all right, here we are, here we are. All right, so we've got £9 in our pocket.
It's wonderful, Marge.
And we're just basically climbing up this ladder if we can. So we got 3 nudges. We could do high, low. Here, best win is £1.20. We're going to go higher. 4 nudges, and we're just going to carry on. And we died. But you know what? I truly believe in the spirit of fairness. I really, really do. As we do this, so we're approaching the 5 credits. And I'm going to leave it like this. I'm going to leave it like this as we found the machine. So someone else can have those 5 credits. And we will take our £9 to one more machine to see what we can do. You know, hopefully it won't be a broken machine like that where things go a little bit wrong. Hopefully not. So this is an oldie, but a classic one that's playing here. Played this a few times in real life as well. I do like this machine. Welcome to Doctor Who. The Time Lord. So we're putting our £9 in here, the £9 that wouldn't go in The Simpsons, which will take us to 45 credits. So we now have no money in our pocket. We have no flowers. We're playing a £6 jackpot machine. What could possibly go right? So we climb this trail, and then you get into the Doctor Who feature. This is old Doctor Who, by the way. You gotta love this tune.
Cyber cash.
No, we don't want cyber cash. We don't want £1.20. Nudge pot is £1.60. No, we don't want that. Use TARDIS. Oh, yes. Let's use the TARDIS. Super jackpot. God, hear that wonderful music. And we get a repeat. No. All canine can help us. That £6 will take us probably to a final machine. You know, things are getting not so good after Duff Beer Guide. And this machine, remember, it's a £6 jackpot machine, so we may not get too much more out of it because it does play exactly as the real machine would play. Come on, canine, give me something good. There, back in again. Alright. Oh, Nuzpot was £3. I should have taken that. Yeah, we'll do the TARDIS again. You know what? We've got £9 back. £1.20, so we're going to go higher. Higher again. Lower. Higher. And we won £3. So there we go. £12 now. God, the Doctor Machine is quite good. And we're back in again. Dear Lord, we're doing alright. Nope. They got me. Oh, that went wrong. That went wrong. Alright, so we're back in the feature again. Come on, just one more win. One more decent win. So Nuzpot is £3. We collect that. Okay, so it's going to be you. There we go. £15. Those flowers are getting closer. But they're still a long way away. Hoping for a spin. Alright, so we might get another £3 if we're lucky. This machine is in a really, really good mood. Oh, they killed us. I pushed it too far. But we're back in because we had the repeat chance. Oh, yes, £6. Alright, I was pushing it to see what we could do. Alright, so we're going to go to, I think, a club machine. You know, it's going to be all or nothing now. So, in real life, this would be a mixture of tokens and cash. Oh, we won! Oh, we didn't win. We didn't win. I thought we got a win. Oh no, it's a restart on this. I thought it was going to give us another jackpot. Hello, Daleks. Alright, so £21. We got £21 to take to the final machine. So we have to collect all this. We've got to collect our tokens and our money. It'll change to pounds soon, I hope. But we're going to pretend it's all cash because, you know what, we're playing a virtual game of get me the flowers or die in a chemical fire. Ah, oh, there's the pounds. Right, a lot of it was tokens. So yeah, let's bring up this and we're going to go to the club machine, the big boy machines now, to try and win our last bit of money. Can the gentleman do it? Is he skilled enough to do this? Well, we will see. We will see. Okay, what shall we pick? What shall we pick? Yes, I know what we're going to pick. We have got £21 to play in Pharaoh's Gold. And this particular fruit machine that you're looking at, this one here, was when I used to design these machines in terms of you would take the flyer of the original machine with the ROMs. This was created by myself. I did this. All right, so let's put our £21 in. So here we are. Here we are, ready to go. Our 21 quid is in there. You know, this is all or nothing. And I've played this machine in real life as well. I've played this one in real life. So, and I know it well. So what you got to do, we've got to climb that 7 trail to the 8, and then the magic begins. If we get bars in play in the middle row here, you can get some of the features quite easily. By basically doing a barcode break thing, I can't remember what it's called, but what essentially does, you crack a code, and where it says trail held, you can unlock any of the other features that are there as well. You know, I'm not too worried for the moment how we're doing, but I think we could do okay. There we go, and we're in. All right, so we're gonna go lower, higher, no. Alright, bring that down. And it could have given us a stop there to let us in. If we had bars there, different bars, we could have got into the feature. Right, so if we'd had that bar on the right down there, we'd have had a chance of a really good crack the code. There we go. Right, so we're going to go for choose a win. Yeah, we're going to choose a win. That'll do, and we'll collect that one. So £7. That could have given us a hold, so we could have held those three bars and hoped for a nudge or a spin in as well. Alright, okay, come on. We've got to make a difference here, we've got to make a difference. And, you know, we are allowed to put the money back in the machine, but this is going to be the last machine that we do. Here we go. So we go for choose a win again. Okay, I went to hit stop but hit the wrong button there. Alright, so let's go lower on the 11. Let's go higher here. We're going to click that. So, 22 quid. I was going for nudges there. Will I get my £100? It's not looking very likely at the moment. Alright, we're in here. So, lower. This is looking quite bad. Oh good lord. Okay. I'm gonna go for we'll choose a win and hope for a higher one. Oh, it's on a 7. Right, let's go for lower. Oh, damn it! Stupid. Oh, come on. Yes! All right. Oh, that's all so good. Higher. No. Right, we've got to collect our £22. And we're going to put it back in the machine for one final run. This is very stupid, very dangerous. I'm at the risk of losing everything. And here we are, we're 49 minutes into this video here. Look how quickly this £22 will go down. This shows you how quickly machines really can eat into money. Alright, as we're on our quest to get £100 for expensive flowers. Sometimes you'll get a nudge if you hold all four. So basically, I'm just playing for the bars, really. Here we go. Choose a win again. Come on, £20. Alright, higher than a 4. We got 11. 9. Oh. I thought we were going to do well there. It was in my water. My water was clearly bad. There we go. We'll take that one. So, we are going to go higher than a 4. No! £12 left. This isn't going well. Right, okay. Choose a win again. Do. Right, I'm going to go lower. Oh. It's great. Yeah, we're not going to do this. Right, higher. Lower. Lower. Money is almost gone. Imagine if we got it on this. Ooh, the last bite of the cherry. You know what? Shall we cheat? Let's drag down the reels. Oh, we can't. No. Ah, that was the one. If I'd done that one, I could have got into here and gambled up. But no, that is it. That is it. Our money is blown. The gentleman is dead meat because his £10 was converted into £11 then, £9 then, £9 again. Then we went up to £18. We put £9 in the machine and lost, and took £9 into another machine that we got to £21. And then we finally blew it all in here. So my quest to buy the missus some flowers with some money that I should have been spending, but I only had £10 left, came to a miserable halt. A miserable, miserable halt. Hope you enjoyed the video. The MFME emulator is absolutely brilliant. These machines play as if you own the real things. You could literally go and buy one of these machines off eBay as a physical actual machine that you can touch and have this emulator running as well, because it's an emulator, not a simulator, and it would play exactly the same if they were side by side with the same conditions for each system. So yeah, had a bit of fun doing this. Not the usual video we do, but you know what? I wanted to do something a little bit different. All of you stay safe, all of you take care, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye. Welcome to the end of video segment. This is Zeus that you can see behind me. Zeus is looking at the purple wall. If you want to see more of Zeus's face, then please like, share and subscribe to these videos. And maybe you'll have more cat heads than cat butts. Stay safe, take care, and I will see you in the next video.